reality in our life is achieved by pursuing excellence over our inner self. This can be done by uniting the mind and the body to overcome our most inner fears. Hello, my name is Marwan Kassouf. We are here today to experience a mental training journey into combative sport. Many incidents have influenced my life as a warrior. The lessons learned from them helped me to achieve a medal at the Olympic Games. The sense of purpose and the knowledge from these experiences can serve as a model to many combative athletes by allowing them to reflect back on their own personal experiences. In turn, the learned knowledge can be utilized to help them succeed in their own performance and in their own sport. At 13 years old, I was in Lebanon fighting with a gun in my hand. By the age of 18, I became a platoon leader. At that time, I moved to the United States and took up boxing as a sport. The commitment to pursue a better lifestyle pushed me to pursue a dream. That dream was to reach the Olympics. Many struggles and obstacles had to be overcome throughout the Olympic trials. At that time, I did not know how to evaluate the process of my success in attaining a medal at the Olympics. Throughout the last several years, while pursuing a higher degree at Cali State Fullerton, I was able to evaluate the process of my success. I found that the process of success is contributed to many continuous motivational factors. For the rest of this video, I'm going to share with you four important components to the process of my success. They are as follows: commitment to achieve goals, mental preparation using imagery, self-control for optimal performance, and concentration. As I present to you these components, using my personal experiences as examples on how to use those techniques to enhance your performance. Think about how you use them or could use them through your experiences to improve your performance or your life in general. This video can be used by any competitive athlete at any level. There is no maximum or minimum usage and is capable to improve performance at any level. The first important component is commitment in achieving goals. A warrior must set a mission to pursue in the quest of excellence in his life. The actions taken to reach the end of his mission are goals being achieved on a daily basis. Goals are actions when the fighters have control over. There are two types of goals: short-term goals and long-term goals. The short-term goals provide an immediate feedback concerning personal progress. Also gives incentive and direction in reaching the long-term goals. For example, while I was training for the Olympics, my main concern was to win the Olympic trials in order to achieve my dream goal. The persistence and the commitment to achieve the daily routine of workout boosted my incentive and my performance for the upcoming event. The feedback that I received gave me an appropriate directions to reach my dream goal, which was the Olympics. I learned that the more challenging the goals are, the more meaningful the performance becomes. The struggle that I encountered in reaching the Olympics increased my drive and my motivation to achieve it. Friends and family laughed at me when I mentioned I'll be in the next Olympics to be. I replied to them, "Don't limit me, not even the sky is my limit. Once you know what you want, then you go and get it. A fighter must be committed and determined to reach his dreams." The positive attitude and the high expectation of yourself enhances your actions toward your goals, which pushes your limitation to a higher level of achievement. The process to succeed is to finish what you start, no matter what the outcome is. For the persistent to attain your goals, the commitment to work extra hard, to put the extra effort, And the determination not to quit too early, it's what's going to make you an excellent warrior. When I was training for the Olympics trial, I was a full-time college student and working a full-time job. The commitment to spend 4 hours of quality workout on a daily basis and to be able to maintain my employment and my academics was possible to accomplish by being persistent. In turn, the commitment helped me in achieving my ultimate dream. As I learned, the important factors in mediating motivational behavior is becoming aware of the goal orientation. They are outcome goals and process goals, which is performance goals. In my first match at the World Championship, my opponent had me beaten 3 punches to 1. As I entered the third round, I knew that I had no control over who wins or loses the match. Rather, I had control over how well I can execute my punches. Then I boxed with every energy I got, giving it 100% to whatever I have. That's 100%. If I had 70%, I was giving it 100% of that 70%, delivering one punch at a time. Suddenly, I was able to knock my opponent out. The lessons learned from this experience is that athletes have control over how well they can do and how well they can perform. But they have no control over who wins the match. For that, athletes don't think of victory or defeat, rather deal with the situation at hand. Trying to accomplish something and falling short of achieving it is not failure. Failure is when we want to accomplish something, but we don't take any effort to reach it. Success is measured by the actions, not by trying. Because when someone is trying, it's just talking about it. But when we are committed to it, is when we are taking the actions. If you acquire skills you've been successful with, and you practice over and over again, then you have the confidence when time comes to test your willpower. A successful warrior knows being excellent is not about being perfect. It's about trusting the inner self and the abilities to overcome any adversity. It's about not being scared to make mistakes, rather to be responsible to learn from them. A fighter does not know his boundaries of the self unless he pushes his limitation to the edge. Working with Cal State University wrestlers as a sports consultant enhanced my knowledge by developing techniques to improve performance for competitive sport. And some of those techniques are, for goal setting, is to develop a journal. A journal can serve as a reminder of all the hard work you did on a day-to-day basis. It also helps to provide you and give you directions in reaching your ultimate goal. When you evaluate your short-term goal, a good habit to develop is to record your feelings and your personal knowledge you gain from your workout, and that is soon after each workout. Then you can evaluate what worked for you and what did not work for you. Most of all, this journal can give you something to reflect back on during a short period of time when you directed so much of energy in pursuing to achieve your ultimate athletic experience, athletic dream. The journal is easy to maintain and anyone can use it. That's how it helped some of the athletes in their performance.
Without goals, you really have nothing to shoot for all year, and a lot of guys were just shooting through the dark without their goals. And once they developed the goal, through Marwan's help, you know, they had something to work for every day. They had the process goals and the outcome goals, and either you reached them or you didn't, but you realized that you had something to shoot for.
What you put in on the wrestling mat, I think decides whether you're going to win or not. What you put in off the mat, what you put in on the road, whether it's running or lifting in the morning or running at night, or just coming in on your own time and wrestling, that's going to decide the match right there. Every wrestler should keep a log or a diary after each workout, right in there, the positive things about the workout, the negative things, what they need to do to improve, what they feel they did that helped them so much, and keep a daily journal of daily practices, and throughout the season, refer back to it, see, and look upon it, see what made you successful, and those are the things you're going to use at the end of the season, and in peak performance time, when it's time to wrestle, time, showtime.
Something was missing, and then, back in the middle of the season, came on Marwan, and he helped us a lot with his mental training. What he did was, he taught us how to make a goal for every practice. Before he came into the room, we made a goal, and then we were committed to the goal for that day. So if I say, well, I'm gonna do, I wrote a sentence in my notebook, and I say, well, I'm gonna do 50 shots, 50 single leg shots, or 50 double leg shots, or this and that. And I was make sure that doesn't matter how tired I was in that day or how much I felt down, I was make sure I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna finish that goal, that I'm gonna accomplish that goal for the day. And it really helped a lot. When those days when I could just barely made it through practice because I was so tired or drained. Marwan taught us how to just do your 100%. If you came into the room and you felt you have only your 70%, whatever you able to do usually, but then that day you just give your 100%, that 70%, okay? So just you basically just do your best all the time, whatever you're capable to do.
A champion must have self-control over his thoughts, that is being aware of any emotional changes in his body language, such as being tense, anxious, angry, and nervous, and having negative self-talk. Once you are aware of the emotional changes, then you can use different techniques to fine-tune yourself for optimal performance. Relaxation is essential for fast and more powerful punching or moving. When muscles are relaxed and loose, then the execution is easier. The circuit of energy has to flow in order to reach maximum contact. And the finest way to do this is by taking a deep breath, then shaking yourself loose. Doing this helps you get rid of excessive tension. Consequently, this will help you balance your intensity prior to taking your shot. The breathing pattern between and before competition in combat plays a very important role in helping an athlete to cope with stress and to help them hold off under pressure. This means that when throwing a punch or taking a shot, it is to breathe out when making contact with your target, such as doing this helps to make you very fluid in executing the movement and helps you conserve energy to carry out the execution of your combination. It also prevents you from getting the wind knocked out when you get cornered after a missed shot. When getting in shape, it usually takes 2 weeks to get your breathing technique and your timing to work for you. Always remember, a champion is a fighter who is calm in the face of the storm. A winner must be able to examine, evaluate, and adjust to the process of his performance in order to execute well. A good hand is to be aware of your body language. If you carry your head with pride or dissatisfaction, if your eyes are alert like a tiger or wandering inattentive to the environment, those feelings that you show on the outside are molded on how you feel on the inside, and your opponent can see that as well. Then you have a choice to make. Either you can have your opponent take advantage and capitalize on your weakness, or you can neutralize and limit his performance. Giving him the advantage increases his intrinsic motivation by expanding his limitational beliefs in his ability to be victorious over you. Remember, the more you project an intimidating look, the better the inner feelings of confidence you have. Nervousness, frustration, anger are the emotions of fully prepared warrior. That occurs when a fighter takes unthreatening situations and makes it threatening. In which case, it could be very detrimental to his combat. While I encounter such emotions at free competition time, I developed a technique to cope with the anxiety and the stress. That is, I would escape the competitive environment to less threatening one by imagining myself I'm out on the beach or on the field or at the park. What am I doing? I'll be playing the frisbee or playing soccer. Then the sense of joy that I would feel from scoring a goal or accomplishing a successful task helped me feel satisfied, which in turn, the feeling of ease of pressure helped to lower my anxiety and that put me in a comfortable state of mind and ready for the upcoming event, for the upcoming competition.
In competitive sport, you cannot afford to lose concentration. If you do, you'll be knocked out or you'll be on your back before you can even realize it. Concentration is there just as the other motivation factors. It can be achieved by dealing with the situation in the here and now. That is, when I'm boxing, I'm focused on my skills, such as breathing, moving, executing the punches, my balance, things like that. The place is here in the ring, and the time is now, at the moment. Accepting this can give you quality time in what you're doing. In combat, the knowledge and the skills you achieve are meant to be forgotten in order to flow comfortably in executing your movement. Because the consciousness of the self can be the greatest hindrance in proper execution. Let it go. Let nature take its course. Do not worry about your performance. Only then you can achieve peak performance. A gladiator in the midst of the battle, do not think about what he's doing, rather he just reacts. The secret to a successful performance is the ability to dismiss mistakes fast and not to dwell on them. That is to clear any negative thoughts and let them go and deal with the situation at here and now. Keeping self-talk to minimum during the match help me eliminate negative self-talk. The less emotions we display at our mistakes, the quicker we can concentrate on the task at hand, the better ability we have over letting them go. Negative thoughts are very, very detrimental to our performance, physically and emotionally. It's very important not to dwell on it. Sometimes it is advisable to have mental rehearsal of the correction of the mistakes after the workout is over. This can give you and help you letting go of your negative feelings about the previous performance. Positive energy and positive attitude help keep you on the appropriate road to fulfill your desire for victory. Turning things around from being negative about something to having a positive attitude toward it helped me to be in harmony by accepting it and being focused on the process that I'm involved in. For example, when I got shot in the war, that was not the worst thing could happen to me. The worst thing could happen to me is being captured and getting killed by the enemy. That thought gave me hope and accept the pain and have the willpower to go on and escaping the area. This experience can be related to my boxing and my athletic performance. Getting knocked down on one of the matches And being on the campus was a great discouragement and a great detrimental to my ego and to my self-esteem. At that moment, then I was able to turn things around. I was able to reflect on all the hard work I did. And that helped me to perceive my opponent as being at least as tired as I was. I turned things around. Instead of questioning my mental state, I was using his condition to boost my ego by saying positive statements with myself, such as, oh, he's nervous, he's tired. That change of attitude gave me positive energy and motivation to stand up and finish the match. To find positive meaning in the pain you encounter will give you hope to rise and triumph through hard times and through the worst situations. A gladiator must enjoy battling, otherwise his fight is never worth the price. Developing the ability to shift your attention from a narrow perspective to a broad perspective and vice versa is very essential to eliminate distractions and to receive the appropriate feedback from your coach in directing your hearing and your vision to help you control the mental focus. I experienced this process at a young age on the front line. When my gun jammed and the enemy was about 50 yards away, I worked on shifting my focus to disassemble the gun and to clear it from the dirt. Then I would broad shift my attention to the environment around me to observe the orientation of the enemy. Then I would evaluate the need of the situation. Am I okay to stay or should I evacuate? After evaluating the proper process and the appropriate feedback, I would shift back my attention to a narrow attention to finish assembling the gun. I relate the same experience to battle in the ring. By being able to pick up the appropriate cues from my coaches, from my trainers, then narrow shift my attention to the fight and the battle at hand, ignoring all the inappropriate feedback coming from the crowd. The best tool I learned to help my concentration during the match is to have a focal point, to bring me back to concentrate the task at hand during the match. When the referee breaks the battle or prior to engagement in the fight, I would pick up a spot with my glove. Then my vision get focused on it. Then my vision is very precise. Then I'm very mentally focused. And my concentration is at its highest level. Which reminds me to be ready by picking up one combination at a time and going for it. For other combative warriors, such as wrestlers, boxers, kung fu players, ninjutsu, can use the same kind of technique by picking up focal points. You can pick up a spot on the mat or look for the size of the mat or the size of the ring on the mat. Others can measure the distance of the ring and I can count the ropes of the ring. Doing this, you will find they are the same as the one you've been spending time on, the one you've been practicing on. The same rings, the same mats, that the one you put the blood and sweat, and that can serve as a reminder of all the hard work and as a reminder to focus on the task at hand and not to focus on the environment, and that can help you to shift your concentration to what are you doing. Usually a fighter in the training program will have difficulty reaching his goals because of low self-discipline. To compensate for this deficiency, I implemented the use of visualization to increase my intrinsic motivation, which in turn made me feel positive about myself. Often I imagine myself walking in the Olympic stadium. The sense of satisfaction enhanced my being by knowing that my goal is within my reach. If I keep working at it. When you see yourself as a confident fighter, that will make you believe in your ability. Imagine yourself as a champion will make you a champion. When you get good at what you do, every small thing counts. For the consistency of being mentally tough is what's gonna give you the edge over the other opponents. On the flight to Korea, where the Olympics was gonna be held, 1988, I mentally prepared myself for the upcoming match by visualizing myself fighting. I saw myself executing my first combination with power, precision, using my ultimate speed. I would box in my mind the 3-minute rounds as if they were the actual match, focusing on delivering 100% of one combination at a time. While I am mentally boxing, I would feel myself taking a deep breath, recalling internally a specific combination to execute. Then I would proceed by visualizing myself executing successfully a specific combination that I had just reflected upon myself. Being mentally prepared gave me the edge over my opponent during the contest by having him fight the way I wanted him to fight instead of me fighting the way he wants me to fight. Being able to see myself taking a deep breath whenever I got myself into trouble served as a survival tool to use when things are not going my way. I often visualize myself as if I'm fighting my ultimate dream match. I image the environment around me as being in the gym. And then when I was practicing, I would image myself as I'm actually in the Olympics. So when I got to the Olympics, I reflected back the same image as I'm in the gym, and that eased my tension, made me relax. Then I would bring my intensity up as if I'm about to compete for the gold medal. That's when I was training in the gym. Seeing myself using the mental cues to remind me of being focused, then I would spar with a positive attitude of winning the contest. I even learned to lower my anxiety level using imagery to turn things around during the match, during the real competition. That is, when perceiving the match as a regular workout, that added to increase my self-confidence by reminding me of all the hard work I spent preparing to get here, which enhanced the trust of the inner self. And that is very important. It also helped me to lower my anxiety. Right before the matches, when things are not going my way, I will close my eyes and I will reflect back, imaging myself on different environment, somewhere less stressful. I will image myself taking a walk. I will image myself walking around the school. I will image myself being with the close friends. And that, escaping that environment, being able to visualize yourself, being able to feel the senses of the other environment, eased off my mind. So when I'm imaging, when I'm imaging my boxing cues, I would actually feel myself executing the punches. I will be able to smell the environment around me. I will taste the sweat dripping down my lips. And doing all that made it feel so real. And that saved me a lot of workout. At the same time, sometimes during my practice of the Olympics, I got injured. And to compensate for that, I was able to use imagery. Being able to go inside the gym, and just to sit down, image myself going through the actual workout, saved me a lot of things. When the time has come to come back and I feel good about working out, I was ready to get back and I was primed for my timing. My timing was good. I did not lose much, knowing that I've been working out in my mind to execute the punches. If there is no struggle, there is no progress. When you love the battle, and find a meaning from all the conflict and the obstacles you go through. When you can put your life on the line for a cause. That is, when I was in the war, knowing that it doesn't matter, I'm willing to die for a cause, for something I believe in. When I step in the ring, I'm willing to die when I'm boxing, knowing that I'm willing to actually put my life on the line, to take a step toward excellence in my life. Only then your journey to excellence is on the road to victory.